San Diego Charger running back number 37, Hank Bauer, who despite the critics last year who said he was too short, not strong enough, not fast enough, was tall enough, was strong enough, and was fast enough to make plays like this. Bauer has come back with a new contract for next season. He's been working out almost every day at San Diego Stadium, lifting weights, and working out here with rookie quarterback Doug Rader out of Tulsa. This sports fantasy a bit different. We have had fan against athlete. This is the first time a professional athlete in one sport wondered what it would be like to go against a professional athlete in another sport. Bauer wanted a hit off Gaylord Perry of the San Diego Padres.
Oh! God, let me out of here, man.
As long as you didn't throw the spitter, you get a chance.
Well, you know, the umpires can't even detect it in the National League, you know, and how are you going to be able to detect it? Just watch it. I know he's going to load one up if I get a hold of one.
I wish you the best of luck, my son.
Thank you. I think I need it.
Hey, look at that.
So before yesterday's day game at San Diego Stadium, Hank Bauer, professional football player, got his sports fantasy to try to hit off another professional athlete, Gaylord Perry.
You guys aren't overpaid like I thought you were.
I thought he looked good, didn't he?
I'm not going to try his sport.
Well, I'll tell you what. I'm inviting you in about 3 weeks to come to training camp.
Why don't you call this a clip? That's the only time I'm going to charge you, big guy.
All right.
We got it.
God, help me. I give up. Thanks a lot, Gay.
Okay, buddy. I see this other guy. Who's this?
Okay, you guys are players, you know that. You're all going to play in this league. Are you ready now to go to Cincinnati?
Yeah, I'm ready. Go.
All right, Luther, Shaq, you got your earmuffs?
We got them.
All right, Gary, you got your big gloves?
Mm-hmm.
Kellen, are you okay?
I don't know, Coach.
Got your body,
kind of dizzy.
Legs, arms,
my
feet? You're together.
Know,
let's go now. Listen to me. Listen to me, please, tease. I hope it doesn't freeze in Cincinnati.
Your daddy.
But even if it snows, we'll still rip their tiger toes in Cincinnati.
Bring your flannel jammies.
Dan'll pass to Eric Sievers. Their defense'll need some breathers. Don Maysick'll hold that line. Doug and Ed'll give him time. Wes and Charlie will get free on our march to victory. Shield'em, Billy.
That looks silly.
Horn in, Bob.
Eat cat kebab.
Let's win in Cincinnati. No one likes to lose to kiddies. It's a rumble.
Brian Gumble.
Rolf Benersch.
Benersch.
Get that Benersch. Stuff. Benersch. I don't know. On our side is young King Williams Buchanan. They'll be bitter.
Kitty litter.
Winslow's gonna jump real high. Woodrow's gonna sneak in low. Gotta block their field goal tries and shut out Cincy. Oh, hi, oh, oh. Let's get on the bus. No more plays to discuss for Cincinnati.
The weather's ready.
Cold.
Man, is it cold? Feel it now.
Put the Bengals down the flusher, then call Howard Slusher. New contracts
for their tailbacks.
We're going to Cincy, that's for sure. Shoot 'em with our howitzer. We gotta chop 'em to their knees. You won't see forest for the trees. The stands will quiet, no more fuss when they see Big Bad Russ.
Washington!
6 hours before the Chargers even touched down at Lindbergh Field, thousands of faithful Charger fans crowded into San Diego Stadium. It was their way to say the Chargers are number one, regardless of the AFC title game. And those who braved the elements were treated to some pretty good entertainment, like the PD5. Then, just after 11 o'clock Sunday night, the Charger bus arrived and the team slowly made its way onto the field. crowd was ecstatic when Charger favorites announced that 1982 will be the year for the gold and blue.
You know, when we were sitting in Cincinnati today and the clock was running out, I just knew that this is the best place in the world to live. Not only because of the weather, but because of you people too, and you proved it. So thank you.
You only wish we could have played that game in another condition, a normal condition. And now we'll have to wait till next year. Thank you.
These guys back here are the best in the world.
Jesse Macias, News 8, San Diego Stadium.
Couldn't believe it. Jeez, that really kind of chokes you up. The great fans in San Diego, just great.
This is great. When we pulled up, someone made a comment. We thought it was a swap meet going on, midnight swap meet. We didn't know, but it's great. As long as we've got the people behind us like this, we're going to go all the way.
Tastes good. It really tastes good. I don't know what it is, but it really tastes good.
Well, I tell you, it's a good feeling to be sitting here right now with that win under our belt.
I tell you, it's been like the whole season for us. You win it, you lose it. All it wrapped up in 1 hour. It was really tough, but it was a full team effort. The Dolphins played extremely tough every minute. It was a hard-fought game.
Never in my life have I played in a game or seen a game as exciting as this one. I think this one should go down in the history books.
Hey, we had a great practice today, and the guys really looked sharp. I think the layoff, the few days off that we had 3 days off total last week, really helped some of the guys get well. This is the first time that I can remember in a month that Dan Fouts and Chuck Muncy and a lot of the other guys participated strongly in practice, and well, we were really sharp, so we're looking forward to great things this week. No question.
Yeah, baby.
Hey, what are you guys doing?
You betcha.
Who's this behind us?
I'll tell you what. You get what you want.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about.
Are you in your house now?
Yeah. Well, I'm sure happy I can be here. It's just, it's delicious to be out here, believe me.
Get the feeling that iron bars and chains couldn't have kept you away.
Well, you know, there are things that could have kept me away, but so far everything's progressing well. I'm just as happy as can be, and I am delighted to be here.
Oh gosh, no. Super Bowl is not until late in January, and here it is just July, and we've just got so much work to do before we even get our first game underway, and we've got a tough schedule again. It just, all the talk is nice, but it really doesn't help us any at this point. You know, a championship would be nice, but that's an awful long way to go, and it won't be decided probably until late in December.
Can't wait, you know. It's better than sitting home. I'd just be sitting home anxious, waiting for the season to start. And this is a good way to ease into it. Practice once a day this week and ease into the 2-a-days next week. And shoot, we got a ball game 3 weeks away. I got to get ready.
I can see you at your apartment now, blocking the walls and the furniture.
I put a few holes in it already.
Oh, have you been a good little girl this year?
Okay.
You'll do almost anything that gets more hair, won't you?
Well, you know, the only thing that upsets me is that I do have a mustache underneath this, and I really don't need a fake mustache. At least that's what I've been told.
What can you promise us Monday night now, Santa?
A lot of hard hitting, and some crazy fans, and a very well-prepared coaching staff, and some players that are going to be unbelievably fired up.
And Santa's going to be good on the special teams?
He'll be down there throwing his body around. Ho, ho, ho.
Now, Bauer is your basic active Santa. He doesn't want to sit down with kids on his knee. He wants to move and push those candy canes.
Merry Christmas. Can you catch? Like JJ? Well, I can't throw like Faust.
Hank said he liked the padding in the suit because he always wanted to look like his teammate, Ed White. And when he ran into some servicemen from Wisconsin, he mentioned that that was the home of former Charger tight end Pat Curran.
You ever heard of Pat Curran? That's okay. Neither is most people in San Diego. But that's okay.
A unique Santa in more ways than one. Merry Christmas, Santa.
Ho, ho, ho.